I think this is a pretty a cool thing you guys are doing. Are there artists around the country that you know of that are doing this? And you plan on like doing like a national alliance and try to make this thing like, you know, a hip thing to do? Like you go to the club and say, where's the painter?
Yeah, there's people all over the country. There's people. There's a guy named Sean Poole that lives in Pennsylvania. There's Frenchie. Down in New Orleans.
Yeah.
There's the guys for Soundtribe Sector 9 with Jay Garcia and Christy.
Norton Wisdom.
And we found out about some people that have been doing it a long time. We found out this guy in New York City that's been doing it for like 30 years. He paints with both hands, and it's called MusicWitness.com. That's his thing, and he does just jazz musicians, but he's done a gamut of people as well for 30 years, you know. So we're finding out about people along the way too, you know. When I initially thought of this gig through Leroy Neiman doing it, you know, doing sports events back in the 70s, you'd see him, and I thought that was a great gig, you know, going out there and you know, doing live events and stuff. So just expansion on that. We like live music and try to transfer that energy. It's a great thing.
It goes back to Kandinsky actually, and some of his studies, and it goes probably further back if you look.
Lautrec with doing like the posters and doing, you know, going inside there and actually doing in coffee houses and doing the seedier side of life per se.
Oh, well, getting ready to talk about the posters. You had mentioned something to me about the posters being in the Denver Art Museum or something like that.
You know what I mentioned was there was a poster art movement back in the late 60s in San Francisco that we all just got to witness a great show and relive the 60s if anybody saw that exhibit at the Denver Art Museum. And what I thought was, you know, how cool is this that they probably, some are unknown artists, you know, and it was tapping into the psychedelic and it was tapping into the unknown. And what I thought, you know, the whole time is not to compare it to posters, but just the free and openness of that is comparable to what's going on and what we do. And I think that back then it was a poster to promote it that was on the wall with tape, and now it's in a museum. And what we're doing, we don't know the future of these things and where they go. And I've given Travis a painting, and you know, I like to distribute these things so that they're in good hands, you know, instead of stacked up like the hundreds that are stacked up there that nobody gets to see. So you know, depending on where they go, it depends on what the future lies with these, you know. It just takes one to open up, and someone opens up to all these, and then all those painters you just mentioned, and kind of group them together in a way.
Hopefully the next time we come together we can have a national panel here, and by next year this will be the norm in the clubs. So if anybody have to say anything in closing?
I really do feel that we're sitting here at the forefront of a very important movement within the arts, and it's really this evolution of performances to extend beyond just being a music concert to being an all-encompassing experience, a gathering for communities, and we're really kind of rebuilding our culture. I think this is a great way to
is anybody painting
reach
this?
Out. Yeah. You know, and so the people that come to these places are inspired, and they take that and they bring that back into their own lives and channel that into whatever form of art that is necessary for them. But we're all artists, and you know, the art and the music are like two sides of the same coin. It's just, you know, it's a multifaceted experience. And I'm so grateful that we're all here talking about it, because it is still new and not everyone's used to it. And that's the hurdles that we're jumping, so that people understand we're not just here to try to paint a pretty picture, but really to expand upon an experience for everyone to really participate in. So
very well put.
I think this is something that happens here a lot. I mean, today we're just giving it a name, and it's called THUNK, and that's the name of it today, but it's been happening for a while, and
right.
Now we're just recognizing it, and we're putting a name to something that's already been happening.
Well, who would ever THUNK, huh?
And I would just want to add that I remember when I go through, especially like my dad and mom's record collections, how identifiable that, you know, when I looked at some old, especially like jazz records, you know, you could look at a record cover and capture almost that period. That's bop, or, you know, that's cool bop, or, you know, however it was, you know, for whatever period it was. There was always an art movement that was associated with the style, mm-hmm. particularly in, you know, the psychedelic era, absolutely, as well. And now that there's so much music that people are just downloading offline, all of a sudden that process gets skipped, where art used to be associated with, you know, your, you know, Led Zeppelin, Houses of the Holy, yes, those Yes records, which was just, I mean, you look at those record covers and it's like, yeah, that music sounds like that. Yeah, absolutely. And it's like, it characterizes so much. Just looking through your collection, you can almost hear the music as it's going by. And so with all the digital downloading and stuff like that, it almost seems like
we lose some of that.
We lose a little bit of that used to be so closely associated with the whole cultural movement of that period. So it's wonderful that, you know, that the artists are wanting to go out and paint and be like on the scene and do their thing. And it really brings a certain, you know, life and cultural movement to everything as well.
Myself, I'm just honored to be here with all this talent, this artistic talent here, and hopefully some of it will rub off on me. All right, we'd like to say goodbye on behalf of Mo Boogie. Thank you very much, and talk about it.
Thanks, Mo Boogie.
Thank you.
Nice. Thank you.